Hello my viewers, today I'll be discussing the summary of a short story, Rappaccini's Daughter. It is a science fiction, it is a tragic story of love. Let's get started with the summary. Rappaccini is a scientist of herbs and plants. He is very keen on making research on plants. He is mad about growing poisonous plants. This guy makes such a medicine from plants which can make human beings poisonous to everything. He has already infused different poisons in his daughter, whose name is Beatrice. He has grown a garden full of plants and flowers, which are very poisonous. There is a special plant which he calls her sister. His daughter, Beatrice, is surprisingly beautiful. She lives among deadly plants and looks after them. A young man lives in a room whose window overlooks her garden. His name is Giovanni. He studies at a university in Padua. When he first sees Beatrice, he is much impressed by her beauty. The more he looks at her, the more he wants to look at her. Soon, he finds himself deeply fallen in love with her. Once he talks about Rappaccini and his daughter with his professor, Baglioni. He doesn't have a nice opinion of them. He tells Giovanni that Rappaccini is making such a deadly poison which will prove disastrous for mankind. He warns Giovanni to stay away from Rappaccini and his daughter as much as he can. But nothing can stop the young lover, Giovanni, from beholding his beloved. So we find him again at the window of his room, looking into the garden and looking for Beatrice. But this time, he notices a couple of strange things happen. She is working in the garden and plucks a flower off the plant that she likes most and calls her sister. A drop of water or two fall on the orange-colored animal walking at her feet and it dies at once. Giovanni is not sure whether what he has just seen is true or his eyes deception. Next moment, he finds an insect hovering around her head. The insect falls down suddenly and lies motionless on the ground. It must have fallen because of the deadly breath of Beatrice. Giovanni throws off a bunch of flowers he has bought. Beatrice picks them up and soon they begin to wither. Giovanni feels very afraid of all he has seen. He wonders whether she is a beautiful or terrible creature. He feels doubtful about her being poisonous, but he is not sure about it. His suspicions wither away as he sees her again. He always avoids meeting his professor, Baglioni, because he always asks him to avoid Beatrice. Help of the keeper of his room, old Lisabetta, Giovanni gets access to a secret door that opens into the garden. Now he starts meeting her very often. Both like each other's company. A few moments before his last meeting with Beatrice, Giovanni is visited by Professor Baglioni. After talking about other matters, Baglioni talks about the most serious matter, the matter of Beatrice. He says there is some strange smell in the room, but Giovanni argues there is no smell. Baglioni says that he has some medicine that can cure the poisonous Beatrice. He says her poison is still curable. He hands him the medicine and leaves his room. Giovanni blows to an insect and finds him dead. Now he also feels the smell Baglioni was talking about. He curses himself and retires to Rappaccini's garden. He blames her for making him poisonous. He calls her poisonous and says she has filled all his blood with poison. He says even her prayers fill the air with death. She admits she is poisonous, but she says she is not responsible for being poisonous. Her father has made her poisonous. She says her body is poisonous, but her soul is free of poison. It needs love and affection. Giovanni makes her drink the strong medicine given to him by Professor Baglioni. Instead of recovering from poison, she dies. Before she dies, she says that Giovanni is more poisonous than her. It means that his words were more poisonous than the poison spread throughout her body. The writer says in the end, poison was her life, so powerful medicine was death for her. I hope you liked the video and you learned something. Bye for now.